protection. Then we've got them with the DSWD. So it's everything is case by case.
What was the common reason why they end up into such end up into trafficking, the victims?
It was in a conference, yung anti-human trafficking conference, but yeah, 2 years ago. Why is this happening? Can I put it this way?
Yeah.
It's a perfect storm.
Yeah.
The Philippines is the perfect place. 7-8 reasons. Number one, poverty. Number two, archipelago, very hard to monitor. Number three, lack of laws against this. Number four, konti na lang laws, bad implementation of laws.
Yes.
Connected to that is corruption.
Yes.
Right?
The judicial. Getting a case put through.
Wala pang 10% success when it comes to prosecuting those who are actually caught. And then you have the migration mentality. Oh, this is tough. Every time there's somebody from the outside coming in, kids are so welcoming, families are so welcoming, right? It's a perfect culture. And it doesn't help, well, the Filipinos with boys, girls are pretty.
Gorgeous.
Gorgeous.
Gorgeous children, yeah.
And in the end, business. I don't know what the state is right now, but what I know is that the three top illegal trades in the world, arms smuggling, drug trafficking, human trafficking. Years ago, human trafficking was the third, but it's now overtaken arms smuggling.
Yes.
And they say it will take over drug trafficking.
It will.
Dahil ang bala, you know, arms, droga, drugs, one use only. But a kid you can use 20, 30 times in a day. So why business, syndicates are involved here.
$32 billion a year worldwide.
But that's 2 years old, right?
That, longer than that, the statistics, I'm sure it's well over 50.